This is October the 1st, and the summer heat wave has came and gone, and we bulldozed the pad here, and this is where we're going to put the hoop house. These are hoops that I bent myself. It's going to be 12 feet wide by about 30 feet long. And these are the bows that I've got. They're 13 feet wide right now, and then they'll be 12 feet once we compress them. And then we're going to run them about 30 feet, 32 feet that way. And this is my first video. This is still the second day. I'm putting in a drainage ditch here on the left side that'll catch runoff from the greenhouse. And I put a string down through there. I think it's going to be about 50 feet long, 12 feet wide. I think I've got a low spot there in the middle. I think I can put the pipe in there, make sure it drains. This is day three of building the hoop house. I have put down the mom fabric. It's a woven fabric. And this is my post that I cut into pieces. I cut this about 14 inches high, I would think. And you can see that I put a string on it. I have those real straight, and they're all concreted in. Put a little concrete in each hole. And put the metal pegs from a farm supply to hold my mat down. I use 3-foot pieces by, I think I got a 3-foot by 100-foot row for about $60. And everything else came from Lowe's. This is a fabric that I have. It's a Sunbelt fabric. It has lines on it that you can use to line up your pots or your greenhouse or how you want to do it. It's Sunbelt. It has a warranty on it. I'm not sure how long it is. I think 4 years. Okay, this is the mom pad. The greenhouse floor, and this is a 40-inch 2x4 that I'll use as a jig off my first post here. This is 40 inches in between every post has had a jig. This 40-inch jig. This is a piece of bamboo that I've cut, and it is exactly 12 feet long. So that means 12 feet long this way is this jig, 40 inches on this jig, and here I have a razor blade. Put a hole in it right there, and this is the crosshair of the post hole. Pull those back, take your post hole diggers, dig the dirt out about 10 inches, and then put a post in here and concrete it in. That's how you jig the post to make sure you have every post exactly the same. 12 feet that way and 40 inches this way on this greenhouse. This is the way that I've spaced my base post for my pergolas. This is the greenhouse with the ground post in. It's still day four. I concreted in all the posts. And I have some hoops here, they fit. Next we'll put the hoops in, and then we'll put a 2x6. Across the front, 2x6 across the back, and then we'll build our M wall there. And I'm also going to put a little porch right here in the front. Saw a video of that. This is day four, and the last video I did, I showed you how to actually use the jig. That you can use the 2x4, but I have some scrap bamboo around here I use for tomatoes, and that is exactly 12 feet long, and in between those posts over there is 40 inches. And in between this post is 40 inches. You see I have a level with a magnet on it that sticks to the post. And you want to watch in between these. The reason I use a jig, that's a 40-inch jig. It's just a little bit over 3 feet. and 12 feet that way, 40 inches this way, and my base post goes exactly right there. I want to show you what I did on the front here. This long piece here is three pieces out of 1 8-foot piece of post that my greenhouse frame will go in. On this front here, I used long pieces. I put about two of those on each end and concreted them in just a little bit deeper because they're going to catch the wind so bad. I don't want it flying off like a kite. And the other smaller post, I cut 2 foot pieces, four pieces out of 1 8-foot piece, and I did the rest of the greenhouse with it. And today we're on the left side, and I use a string right down the middle, and also put a string from this side to that side, and I have that level. So I'm kicking off this post right here, and that'll finish our day on the base post for the fourth day. Today is day 5, and I spent the day, the last few hours, 5 hours, bent the last of the top rail fence into the frames. And what I had to work with was this 10-foot piece, 18-gauge top rail fence. I used two of those. I marked my joints with a little green paint. So I marked every one of those with a little green paint. I haven't screwed them in yet, and they're not exactly straight yet. This is what I'm working with. You can actually pull it up and down out of the post. I will screw those in 1 foot, 1 foot in each post. I'm gonna do one side. I'm gonna do the left side first. It'll get screwed in, and then I'll pull everything straight and just do it by just doing the left side 1 foot. I want to mark it with a piece of tape on the 1 foot that goes down into the footer post, and then from there I'll mark my right side. I'll pull my right side straight, and then I'll take my time and put one bar that runs all the way down the middle. I'll probably put it in with plumbing tape. It's a metal tape that comes on rolls and has little holes in it. And I'll also connect my end walls with plumbing tape, or I'll build my end walls using those brackets, plumbing tape brackets. And this is day 5, and I think this will conclude this video, and we'll move on to the next video, which will be bracing, straightening, and rolling on plastic.